Hello Ken, good evening.
Hello,
Hello
teacher.
Ken, good evening. Yes, so can you hear me well?
Yes.
Okay. So can you see the screen clearly?
Yes, I can.
Okay, very good. So this time we're going to continue our lesson in Unit 2A, which is the listening. I want you to practice reading the transcript. We're done with this one, right? Are we done with this slide, Ken? Yeah, are we done with this slide? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, so where now? How about this one? Are we done with this?
No.
Okay, so I want you to practice reading this transcript and please read loudly.
Teacher, I can see the screen clear.
Not clear? You mean not clear?
Yes.
Okay, so go to your Zalo. I sent you a friend request. Kindly accept me in Zalo, Ken, so that I can send the picture to you in Zalo. Okay, here it is. Thank you for accepting my request. So here it is. Did you see the picture? I'm sorry, why is this that it cannot be? Wait a minute, Ken. Did you see the picture, Ken? Yeah, did you see the picture? No.
No, I haven't.
Yeah, wait me a minute because my screen is very lag. Yeah. Next week Tuesday, Ken, I want you to enter the Zoom at 8:45. Okay, so that we can finish our class early. Is that okay with you? Hello, Ken?
Yes.
Would it be okay for you to enter the class 8:45?
It's okay.
Okay, so do that one so that we can finish the class early. But please wait me a minute because I'm going to Zalo to send this picture. Anyway, how are you today, Ken?
Very fine.
Did you have your dinner already? Yeah, I think I sent the picture in Zalo. In the group chat. I'm sorry. I sent the picture in the group chat, not in you. So let me send this one again. Yeah. So done. Okay, so did you see? Okay. So I want you to read that one loudly, Ken.
One, war with the beach, hungry for adventure. Why not spend 7 days in a remote and beautiful landscape in Alaska? Kayak across icy lake and shallow rivers, see eagles, bear, and other fascinating wildlife. Or just enjoy the amazing scenery on your journey through tall mountains and deep valley. the view of the mountain as you kayak across the lake is unforgettable. Two, for experienced divers only, this holiday offers an amazing chance to explore the Rocky Cave along the coast of Mexico. You can only reach some of these areas by boat, a boat that will be your home for 5 days. After 3 days near the cave, the boat leaves the steep cliff and head for the ocean for 2 days, a chance to see some of Mexico's amazing marine wildlife. Three, on this week, 7 day walking holiday in the Philippines, you see mountains and valley, lakes and forests. But the highlight of the week is the chance to stand beside Lake Pinatubo, a lake inside the volcano. 30 years ago, this lake didn't exist at all, but when Mount Pinatubo erupted in 1981, the top of the volcano blew up, a shallow lake formed, which soon became deep because of all the rain. Take a break from the tropical heat by enjoying a swim in this beautiful and exotic natural feature. For John Forrest Chicker on a Canadian adventure, you never forget, we offer a 2 week journey through the spectacular scenery of Canada. See the part of the country that most tourists never reach. Kayak down narrow river under the trees and or walk across narrow wooden bridge. Find dark caves behind tall waterfall. We promise you will fall in love with this exciting and magical landscape with its tall trees, clean waters, and clear blue sky.
Okay, so thank you for reading that one. Ken, I see that you're a great reader, and so far, your pronunciations are all good. So now, I want you to read the cycle box. Then you complete the sentences below with there is or there are, and match them with photos A to E. There is one extra photo. So please remember that we use there's or there is for singular countable nouns and uncountable nouns. Teacher, what do you mean by singular? That means only one. And we use there are for plural nouns. What do you mean by plural? That is more than one, two or more. Example, there's a forest. We use there's or there is because forest is only one. There are trees, we use are because trees are many. There's some snow. Snow is just uncountable nouns. So for this one, do you have any question regarding there is and there are, Ken?
No.
Okay, so please answer or you write your answer there. Okay, so where is your answer now, Khan? Did you write your answer?
Yes, I did.
Where did you write?
Number one, there's a clear blue water all around.
Number
Number
two.
two, there is grass in the valley and there are also some trees.
There are. How about
number
number
three,
three?
There are trees and bush on and bus side on up the river.
You say bushes.
Bushes. Number
How about
four,
number four?
There is snow on the top of the mountain.
Great job. Okay, so now Ken, I want you to match sentences with the photos A to E. There's one extra photo. Number one, there's clear blue water all around. What picture is that?
Picture D.
Very good. There's grass in the valley and there are also some trees.
Picture A.
Very good. This is letter B. There are trees and bushes on both sides of the river.
Picture E.
Okay, this is letter A. There's snow on the tops of the mountains.
Picture B.
This is picture E. Yes. So for this one, let's proceed with the next slide. I want you to read the text and you find the name of the person in photo. Do you agree with the theory at the end? Why or why not? So Ken, do you know how to write in Zoom? Do you know how to write in Zoom?
Maybe no.
No? What do you mean? You don't know how?
Yes.
Okay, wait a minute because I'm going to find. I'll ask help so that you'll know how to write in Zoom. Okay, so here and while waiting, wait a minute. Okay, so while waiting for someone to enter in Zoom and tell you how to annotate, I want you to read the text loudly about exploration. Can you please read this one?
Can you send it to Zalo?
You still can't see this one clearly. Does my screen is still blur, Anne? Hello, Anne. Is it blur or not?
Yes.
Okay. So I sent you now. Okay, did you see the picture? Please read that one loudly, Ken.
Yesterday, 16-year-old Hector Turner began his attempt to become the youngest Briton to complete a 242-kilometer ultramarathon marathon across the Sahara Desert. On the same day, Jordi Stewart, a 20-year-old university student, set off for Everest. He wanted to be the youngest Briton to achieve the the seven summit challenge, climbing the highest mountain on each continent. Last year, Mike Perham circumnavigated the world along by boat at the age of 17. Why do today teenagers feel this need for exploration and adventure? Why do they want to have wild experience? Mike Burham has a theory. Kids dream more than adults.
Okay, so are you done reading, Ken?
Yes.
Okay, so let's just wait for someone to enter the Zoom so that she or he will teach you how to annotate, like write in Zoom. Okay, we will just wait for her to get inside again in our meeting.
Hello teacher, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, sir. Good evening.
Nguyễn Khang ơi. Okay, let me have the student. Nguyễn Khang ơi. Nguyễn Khang ơi, con bật mic lên đi.
Dạ đây cô.
Đầu tiên con thấy con di chuyển. Con chuẩn lên trên góc chính cùng của màn hình, con thấy hai ô màu xanh và một ô màu đen chưa? Có chữ view option ấy. Quên khách rồi.
Đừng có nói nhỏ con không nghe coi.
Tức là con bây giờ con di chuyển, con chuẩn lên trên cùng của màn hình, con có thấy hai ô màu, màu xanh lá cây và ô màu đen không?
Do màu xanh lá cây mà có chữ You are viewing picture I am screen đó cô.
Con thấy rồi đúng không? Thì bên cạnh có ô màu đen là view option ấy, con thấy chưa?
Thấy rồi.
Thì con bấm vào mũi tên chỉ xuống có chữ annotate tick đấy. Thì con click vào xong con vẽ lên màn hình cho chú xem nào. Ok. Teacher, you can continue the class.
Yes, thank you so much, sir. Have a good night.
Goodbye.
Bye. Okay, so do you know now how to annotate and can?
Yes.
Okay, so I want you to answer this one. Do you agree with the theory at the end? Why or why not? Do you agree with the theory at the end? Why or why not?
Yes.
Why? Because? Because? Why do you agree with the theory? Support your answer. Yes. Why do you said yes? Why is it that you agree with the theory at the end? Support. You need to support your answer, Ken. Okay, so here it is. That's here. I want you to find the name of the person in photo. What's the name of the person in photo, Ken?
The person in photo, he might perhaps.
Okay, that's Hector Turner or Mike Perharm. Very good. So do you agree with the theory at the end? Why or why not? You said yes, so why? Okay, so here, yeah, I want you to complete the table with words from the text. Okay, so you can write your answer here. Ken, take your time. Okay, I'll give you example. So the verb attempt, the noun would be, I'm sorry, this is attempt, still attempt. Number two, completion. If the noun is completion, the verb would be complete. Okay, so you proceed, you continue with number 3 to 7. You write your answer there, Ken. Do you have answers now, Khan? You use your pen in Zoom so that you can write on the screen. If you don't know what's the noun and verb, you can also use your dictionary. Yeah. Okay, do you have answers now, Khan? What's your answer in number three? What is the verb for achievement?
Achieve.
Okay, that's achieve. Very good. How about the noun for the need?
Need.
Okay, that's need also. How about explore? Noun for explore.
Exploration.
Great job. How about experience?
Experience.
Great. How about the verb for dream?
Dream.
Okay, you got a perfect score here. So now, Ken, since it's almost time, do you have any question to me before we end our class?
No.
Okay, so please take note that next week, Tuesday, you enter the Zoom, the same link, 8:45 p.m., okay?
Yes.
Okay, so goodbye, Ken.
Bye.